is a WVVA Sports Special. High School Football Game of the Week is brought to you by Hardee's, Ramey Chevrolet, Tazewell, Virginia, by Twin State Distributing, distributors of Rocky Top, Bluefield Community Wellness Center, and by your local IGA stores. And welcome again to High School Football 1987. Hi, everybody. I'm Ralph Oakley along with Matt Pumo. We've got seven great ball games for you this fall. And we're starting off tonight with one of the best always, and that is Bluefield against Graham. Matt Pumo, what do you think about the ball game? What's the key?
Well, for Graham, defensively, they're going to have to try to contain Bluefield's speed. Bluefield has a lot of speed this year. Graham is a little bit smaller as well. They want to try to keep Bluefield in the middle of the field and don't let him get outside.
And what will Graham do on offense?
Graham is going to try to run the ball right down the throat to the Bluefield Beavers.
We've got a lot of great games coming up this fall. I understand that Graham has a really, really tough schedule, especially early in the season.
Yeah, their first 3 weeks are pretty tough. Besides playing Bluefield, they also got to play Princeton. And we know Joe Tribuco and his squad is always tough.
Well, this will be a great game to start off our season. It's Bluefield against Graham at Mitchell Stadium. We'll be back with the starting lineups and the kickoff in just a moment. Welcome back to Mitchell Stadium. Here's the kickoff as Bluefield will be kicking off to Graham. And the ball taken in the backfield by Palmer. Palmer up across the 15. Across the 30 and tackled at the 32-yard line. So Graham will have it first and 10 at the 32. They'll be going from south to north. First down and 10, they mark the ball at the 31. We've had a little bit of rain this evening before the game, but not enough to affect the field. It looks to be in gorgeous shape. First play around the side goes John Groff, and Groff's going to be knocked down basically at the line of scrimmage for only a yard.
We got a turnover, fumble, Bluefield ball, I believe.
That is the case, it was a fumble, and that we'll have to check. John Grubb with the carry fumble, and was picked up by Bluefield. We're trying to check on the recovery, so Bluefield will take the ball over. So we'll have to get back to the Graham starting lineup when they get the ball back. At quarterback for Bluefield is Stacy Carter. On the front line, Lambert, Skeens, Music, Street, and Mead. The ends are Arnold and Thompson. And back to pass quickly is Carter looking right. Has a man open in the corner. It is just tipped away from Stepline. A beautiful defensive play made
Tony Palmer
by number 23. Tony Palmer. Stepline was open, but the ball was just maybe a little underthrown. Yeah?
You know, and it may be because the ball's maybe a little bit wet. The field, as you said, was a little wet. May have slipped out of his hands because he didn't gun it like he should have.
And Coach Brett Simon looks like he wants to strike very quickly on that turnover.
That's right. Well, it's always a good thing to do. When you get a turnover, a lot of coaches like to strike quick, and they've got good field position. Why not go for it?
So second down and 10 at the 31. At quarterback, junior, 6 foot 165, Carter. Here's a handoff, trying the left side without much success. For Bluefield is Todd Benners, number 10. And he gets maybe a couple down in the 29. It'll be third and 8. Third down between 7 and 8 yards. Here's Carter, handoff right side, and a good defensive play by Graham.
Rodney Hairston made that tackle.
Hairston, as the linebacker, came through and made a fine play to tackle Ronnie Scott. And they're really pretty much, I would think, in the four-down zone here, Matt.
Oh, definitely. No question about it. Looks like they might even be going for it.
You say what kind of field goal kicker, but that's a heck of a long field goal.
That would be probably about a 42 or 3-yard attempt. Probably a little hard for the holder maybe to handle the ball because it is a little damp out there. So they'll go for it on 4th and 6. Stacy Carter comes right. Here's the pitch. He's got his man.
He read it. He cut it back inside. Nobody touched him. Easy touchdown for 6 for Bluefield.
So a 25-yard run. Better at 9:48 in the first quarter, and Bluefield gets on the board very, very quickly. Stepline to hold, and Arnold's going to try the point after attempt. 6-0 our score. Here's the snap, the kick, it's up, and it's good. Bluefield with Benners on the 25-yard run, Arnold on the kick, it's 7-0. And now the kickoff coming up. Zabook from Paul Wallace, it's a good kick down the middle of the field.
Rick Ferris got the ball.
Ferris with the ball coming up the middle, comes across the 30 to the 31. So Graham will have the ball once again, and I'm sure they're going to try to hold on to that football, man.
Yeah, they have good field position. You know what? Getting back to Bluefield real quick, what a way to start off the year after coming off a bad year. Coach Simon's second year with the program, they score first possession, and you know they got to like that.
In the backfield, at quarterback,
Mike Arthur,
sophomore,
14 years old.
Mike pitches the ball left to Tony Palmer. Palmer with no room will be tackled for a loss. Great defense there.
Has Jeff Browning. Jeff Browning made a nice play there, Ralph. Read it well. Went to the ball. He attacked the football.
We'll call that about a loss of two, so it'll be second down and 12. At quarterback, Mike Arthur. Second down, 12. Here's a handoff up the middle. And very little room. That was Palmer, maybe back to the line of scrimmage. It'll be third and 10. And on the tackle was the linebacker, Mike Miller. Front line for Bluefield defensively, Arnold, Kevin Ellison, Mark Maddow, and Gravely. At the linebackers, we have Lambert and Miller.
Well, we'll get to see what kind of arm Mr. Arthur's got right away. Third and 10.
That's a tough way for a young sophomore to have
That's
to try
right.
it out.
That's right.
Clock counting down, 8:20 to go. At center, Tim Wright. Front line includes Browning, Woody, Wright, Johnson, and Rhodes. Goodson and Johnson are the ends. Johnson split out wide to the left. Here's the pitch. They'll go right with it. It's Grubb again. This time the play works. He's up across the 40 to the 45 and a first down. And that was primarily the same play they fumbled on, but that time they got the blocking.
Beautiful run as well. As you notice, he had the spin move right at the end just to get the extra yard to nail that first down. Beautiful run right there.
Into the football game comes Rusty Bradshaw. They line up tight. Arthur up over center. Here's a handoff. Left side, it's Grubb again. He's got room, it looked like. But Bluefield hung right with it. And we'll call it a two-yard pickup once again.
That was Browning.
The tackle was Lambert.
I tell you what. With Graham having a smaller line, it looks like they're going to be running a lot of counters and a lot of trick plays to compensate for their lack of size against Bluefield's defensive front.
Second down and 5. Arthur, right up the middle they go for maybe a yard or two.
Rodney Hairston.
It'll be third down and 4, so another critical third down opportunity. I would imagine at this point, Graham is just trying to maybe stabilize themselves a little bit after that shock on the start of the game.
That's right. Plus, with a young quarterback starting his first game, they're just like a feeling out process.
So we've got third down and about 3 yards to go. Graham has crossed midfield into Bluefield territory at the 49. Bringing out wide to the right is Goodson. Line up right behind him is Tony Palmer. Now, Woodson comes in tight to the line. And we have some movement. Going across was the Bluefield defense. We'll have to see if he was drawn off there. That was
like Joe Street.
And it is offside, so.
Going to give us a first down.
Good patience on the front line. They were able to see the Bluefield defense come over, and they're going to get a free first down. Those penalties can kill you sometimes.
That's right, and he may have even changed up the cadence a little bit there.
So it'll be first and 10 at the 44. Clock now down to 6:15. We had just a little bit of rain, Matt, right before the ball game. But I think the pretty afternoon we had, maybe the field got pretty well dried out, it looks like.
Yeah, it doesn't seem to have affected any of the play so far, except maybe the first pass.
Here we go. The pitch is Bradshaw left side. Nowhere to go. Great defense by Bluefield. That's going to be a loss of 4. In on the tackle, we had a couple of people. Number 84, Gilbert, was in on that.
Steve Arnold was there. Nice play by Arnold. That's where the size will come in for Bluefield. They may be able to overpower the Graham front.
As you had mentioned earlier, it appeared that Graham's going to maybe try to work away from the middle, maybe run a lot of counters, run out to the side. But so far, with the exception of the one nice run by Grubb, Bluefield's been able to do that.
That's right. Well, they've got to do something to counter that size.
So second down and 12, back at the 47. Arthur pitch right. It's going to be Grubb, and Bluefield is absolutely all over him, and about another loss.
John Lambert, beautiful play.
so far.
They seem to be able to either, I don't know if they're cutting through the traffic or coming back around as those guards are pulling. We'll have to take a look at that.
He just blew in there. Last two plays are just blown through.
So that moves him back across midfield. It's third and about 18 yards to go. 4:50 to go in the first quarter.
Maybe we'll get the first pass for Graham offense.
Johnson comes out. Luther Johnson, 6'3 senior, out wide to the left. Let's watch for him. Here's a quick one over the middle. It's complete to Goodson. Goodson very close to the first down. Just a quick hit with a tight end, a quick slant in. A nice throw there, just dumped over the middle by Arthur.
One of the toughest passes to defense in all of football, the quick hitter. And as you see, Ralph, we got a first down on the play for Graham, and they're marching.
Got to be impressed with Arthur there. That's a real touch pass, and instead of just airing it out and getting the cobwebs out, he had to really throw a nice touch pass, and he did it.
The middle was wide open for Goodson as well, wide open. And he made a nice move to get the first. Oh, it
just
is four.
Just
a little short.
First down. It little looks short. Like about a foot, and obviously they'll be going for it. Right at the 34-yard line, they've got about a foot to go, and we have a whistle. Timeout, Bluefield. After that timeout from Bluefield, fourth and just a foot to go.
And Ralph, it looks like number 70, Jeff Browning, left tackle and linebacker, checked into the backfield for Graham. Little William Perry action.
Sammy Carriers, he already
he carries
he
it.
He carries it.
First down.
It. And you can see why that worked.
Got a flag on the play.
But he carried a couple of tacklers forward. He made it by plenty.
The reaction of the Graham players looks like it's against Beaver, and it is.
It might have been, I think, maybe an accidental face mask. I'm not sure. It was thrown right on the tackle, so we'll have to wait and see. 15-yard penalty is going to take the ball down to the 15-yard line. It was a face mask. Reasonably sure that was not intentional. It just looked like in the struggle. They wanted to bring him down, and they grabbed the face mask. A big break for Graham. And they've got it first and 10 from the 15-yard line. Rick Ferris in the backfield. I don't believe he's carried the ball yet this evening. Arthur hands it off to Ferris. Right side. Ferris with almost nowhere to go. We'll call that one no gain.
Good defensive penetration by the Beaver front line again.
Great crowd on hand tonight, even with the threatening weather. Everybody with their umbrellas and overcoats in case it does rain. It's a cool night, a little bit of humidity, and I say we've got easily 10,000 people here tonight, as we always do, for this game to start off the season. 3:10 to go, first quarter. Bluefield up 7-0, 25-yard touchdown by Betters. Now Graham's knocking on the door. Here's a handoff left side, nowhere to go, a loss of two. And that Bluefield front line is really just firing through there. John Grubb was tackled up for about a two-yard loss.
Well, as we mentioned earlier, Ralph, they have a lot of beef up front. A lot of beef up front.
They'll face a third down and 13 from the 18-yard line. Graham has marched the ball well down the field. They started this at, I believe it was a 31-yard line. And a long run by Grubb on third down, a nice pass over the middle to Goodson, although it didn't pick up the first down, got them in position.
This is where it counts, though. This shows what kind of offense they have.
Third down and 13. Arthur left side, and in the backfield once again, number 70.
That's
Browning, and he picks up about 3 yards on the carry. I'll tell you what, he's got some quickness.
Excellent. So far, he's playing a great game.
It looks like we may be trying a field goal as they bring some people in. Well, look, it's fourth and 10 from the 15. We'll wait and see what happens. It looks like that's exactly what they're going to do.
Rick Brown. That's it, Brown.
Rick Brown will be trying it from the 22. That will make it a 32-yard kick. 142 and counting down. First quarter. Here's the snap, the place. The kick is up, and the kick is just no good. I think it just fell short. He had the right line, but it just fell short of the crossbar. So Bluefield will take over first and 10. Bluefield back with the football after that field goal that just missed short. First and 10, they put the ball in play at the 20. At quarterback, 6-foot junior Stacy Carter. Here's the handoff. Lots of room there. for Scott. Scott coming up the right side nearly to midfield. He'll be dropped at the 45 for a 25-yard pickup.
Rusty Bradshaw saved a touchdown.
He got open quickly and had some daylight, but as Matt pointed out, Bradshaw saving a touchdown. But nonetheless, a big pickup for Beaver. They're up to the 45, a 25-yard pickup.
Good indication right there of the speed of Bluefield. He got outside what Graham does not want to happen.
Bluefield line doing a good job of blocking tonight. Out wide to the left, Thompson, stick line in the slot. Hand off, second man through.
He's gone. Outside.
And he's going to be down to the 40, the 35. We have a flag, though, man. Carrying the football. Was that Wallace, I believe? First down the backfield. We have a flag, though, at the 35, away from the play. We'll have to see what that was. And it was Cliffy. They got it down, Marcus, first and four. So they just take the play, minus the penalty, first and four. Here's the pitch, right side, it's Scott. He gets a little room to the outside, across midfield for the first down, down to the 48. Or make that the 43, rather. First and 10 for Bluefield. Ball at the 43-yard line. Wide to the right is Thompson. Carter doing a good job at quarterback. In motion comes Scott. He'll try the left side. It's Batters. He's got room. Cuts back to the middle of the field. Now coming to the right side. And Bradshaw once again saves the touchdown, tripping him up at the 25. He went left down the middle and then to the right.
Looks like Jeff Browning is down on the ground for Graham, holding his left knee.
As they come back to action, Browning being helped off the field. Looks like the left knee. We'll have to check and see if we can get a report on that. Both teams had some injury problems, some accident problems coming in. This is not the kind of thing they want. We hope it's not too serious. Come back to action. It'll be first down, 10 yards to go from the 27-yard line. Bluefield running the ball very well tonight. In the backfield, Arthur. Over center. Handoff is Benners. He comes up across the 25, down to the 23, gain of 7. And we've come to the end of the first quarter of play with our score, Bluefield 7, Graham 0. We'll take a timeout and be back in a moment. This is the WVBA High School Football Game of the Week. With Matt Pumos, start of the second quarter. First play of the scrimmage, Ronnie Scott tries to run right side without much success, and that'll leave it at third and three. Matt, we've got some good ball games coming up this season.
That's right. The next game we will televise will be Saturday the 12th. It'll be the Bluefield Beavers at home taking on Greenbrier East.
Be sure to join Matt along with Tony Calabro. Tony will be back with us this season. And we'll be talking about all the games we've got a little bit later on. But right now we've got a good one. Bluefield leads 7-0. They've got the ball at the 20. Knock on the door. They lead 7-0. Third down and three. There's a handoff left side. It's better. He gets across the 20. Knocked down at the 17. I think he's maybe just a little bit short.
Chris Patton made the tackle. Tripped him up behind the line.
That's going to be close. I think it's going to be fourth and about a yard or two. We'll wait and see what they're going to do. Are they going to kick or are they going to go for it? It would be about a 35-yard attempt. My reaction is with the success they've had, they'll probably go for it.
Yeah, I would imagine you'll see a running play. Something to the outside I would look for.
Fourth down, about 2 yards to go. Ball at the 18. Thompson wide left, stuck line in the slot. Let's see what happens. Handoff, second man through. It's Scott. He's down to the left side, down to the 5. And he'll have the first down with first and goal to go. Ronnie Scott, and again, it was that speed you talked about, Matt.
That's what Coach Carlick was worried about all week preparing for the game, trying to contain that speed and contain him inside.
Other ball games we'll have for you this year. We've got Richlands, Tazewell, Mountview at Princeton, Princeton at Bluefield, Parkersburg at Woodrow Wilson, George Wythe at Graham. So we've got some great high school football for you this fall. Of course, we started off earlier this week. Matt and Jim Connors had our high school preview. Should be a great season for football. We've got first and goal for Bluefield at the 5-yard line. Here's a handoff up the middle. Benners close to the touchdown, but just short. They'll mark that one between the 1 and 2 yard line. Benners trying to get on the board twice early. Bluefield line doing a great job.
Oh, they're just blowing them off the ball. Blowing them off. That's what you want when you got a running attack.
Mike Miller comes in the football game. He's a 5'11", 195-pound senior fullback. Carter doing a good job of handling the ball tonight. Second goal from the one. There's a handoff. It's Miller. And it's a touchdown. Miller, the fullback, comes in. Knocks it over from 1 yard out. So with 9:44 to go, it's now 13-0 for the try for the extra point coming up. Arnold in to try his second extra point of the night. Hit the first one right through the middle, holding his stick line. Snap's a good one. It's down. The kick is up. And the kick is good. So two in a row now for Arnold. That makes our score 14-0. Bluefield leads 9:44. Bluefield a 14-0 lead. Lost the kickoff. It's a low knuckleball. That's going to be a tough one to handle. But they finally do it. Rick Ferris, he's going to try the left side, trying to get outside across the 20. He'll be knocked down at the 26-yard line.
Looked for a minute like he might have some room.
Yeah, he did have some room, but Joe Skeens closed it down quick and nailed him.
Mike Arthur, the quarterback. Graham did move the ball in their last possession, just came up short and missed the field goal. So they have had success moving the football. Here's a whistle. The handoff was to Bradshaw, but there was movement on the line before the play got started. So we have first down and 15 after an illegal procedure penalty called against the G-men. First and 15 from the 22. Mike Arthur. Well, after some areas, it's going to be Bradshaw up the middle, and he'll get it back up to the 25-yard line. But wrestled down by the Beavers in on the tackle number 14. The safety, Stacy Carter, came up and forced that action.
Graham seems a little bit reluctant to put the ball in the air so far in this game. They've only thrown a one pass, and they got some nice yardage out of it.
I don't believe Bluefield threw one pass the first pass of the game.
First play of the game.
And was just knocked down. So both teams trying to run the football. They both have moved the ball with pretty good success thus far. Back in action, second down 12. Brian Rose hurt, and we have a replacement in the ball game.
Kenny Perkins was hurt, I believe, wasn't it? 61.
Perkins, rather. I'm sorry.
Yeah, Perkins was hurt.
On that play. So second down 12. Bradshaw tried left side, and there's nowhere to go. A loss of three on the play. And Bluefield's doing a great job on defense.
That's right. Their size is a lot. There's a lot more of an advantage size-wise for Bluefield than I had thought previously. They really have a lot more bulk than Graham does.
Third down, 14 to go. MacArthur getting his team set up. It's the pitch.
Oh, and he's going to be brought down again. Bradshaw, are they going to rule that a fumble?
No, I believe they're going to. It looks like they're going to rule it down. Well, once again, Bradshaw tried to sweep to the right and just cutting through. Beaver doing an outstanding job. And Graham's going to have to punt.
Big play by Joe Street. Big play.
This will be our first punt of the ball game. We expect to see either Rick Ferris or John Grubb doing the punting. Back for Bluefield, we have Benners and Wallace. They're staying just past midfield. It'll be John Grubb punting. He'll be staying at his own 5-yard line. 7:38 to go, second quarter. Snaps a low and he gets it on the bounce. Gets the kick off. It comes end over end out of the right side. Gets a good kick. It'll be taken by Walsh. Just past midfield, the 45, and out of bounds at the 39-yard line. So Bluefield will get the ball with good field position.
They've had pretty much good field position. Their first touchdown. They've got it again now. See if they open it up.
Looks like a pass. Carter looks right. And they were setting up the screen pass for the end Thompson, but he threw it short. Incomplete.
Good surge by the Graham defensive line there.
He had a couple of blockers out there. If that pass had been a little bit higher, he might have picked up some yardage.
Got a little quick feet. Felt a little pressure.
Second down, 10 after the incomplete pass by Carter. Thompson breaks out wide to the right. He's going to go up again, looking down the middle. He's got a lot of pressure, and he's going to be brought down. Good.
Rodney Hairston and Rodney Hairston and Keith Woody. Hairston came from the linebacker position.
That's the kind of momentum that Graham probably needs. That'll be a loss of five. Back after a timeout, third and 15. Carter knocked down on the play by Hairston. See if they'll try to put it up for the third straight time. Carter fakes a handoff. Pass time. This time he's going to throw
wide
it.
Wide open.
Stickland wide open. And Dyson just misses the ball. Just a touch overthrow. Stickland made a good effort. And it was 6 inches from quite a gain.
He had good 5 yards on the nearest man. Heck of an effort.
So now Bluefield will have to punt. A stick line had beaten the secondary by 10 yards.
He had two guys beat. Graham catches a break.
And a punt, Todd Benners. First punt of the night for Bluefield. Poor snap. He's going to get it off quickly. And it's a good end over end kick. And it's going to go out. Let's see where the referee marks it. He's going to go back up to the 20-yard line. So Graham will have it there, first and 10. 6:27 to go now in the second quarter. Bluefield leads 14-0. So Graham will try to get something going before the half here. Here's a handoff, left side, and nowhere to go for number 23, Tony Palmer. May have gotten back to the line of scrimmage.
Looking down the season, some of the highlights we're looking forward to this year, we'll have the dedication game over at Princeton, their beautiful new facility. We're not sure which one that'll be yet, but we'll be over there for that. It'll either be hopefully with Bluefield or Mountview. Now we have a whistle on the play. I believe we had a little movement before the snap.
Illegal procedure called against Graham. Procedure, a decline. Second down. It was marked off six to be second and 16. Illegal procedure against Graham. Got a little movement on the line. Here's a pass over the middle. It was intended for Luther Johnson and just off his fingertips.
They didn't drop a flag. No flag was dropped, but it did look like he moved a little ahead of the snap.
That was basically the same little slant, and that time from the left that they completed it earlier. The good thing this time is that Johnson, he couldn't hold on to it, so it'll be third and 16. If they can't convert here, a punt will probably give Bluefield once again that good field position.
And Bluefield will probably have plenty of time before half to punch in another score.
Bradshaw wide to the left.
Straight
looking
drop.
Right. Arthur is going to get nailed in the backfield. All
flag.
Of a sudden, his pocket just absolutely collapsed. As Brad points out, we have a flag. He was knocked down at about the 8-yard line. And it's a face mask against Bluefield. That'll be the second call against Beavers tonight for that same infraction. Yeah. And it happened so quickly, the pocket looked pretty well set up, and you blinked, and all of a sudden he was down.
It definitely closed up around him, another 15-yarder.
But that won't get them the first down. That'll make it about third and 7. 5:23 now to go in the second quarter. Bradshaw again out to the left. Looking to pass Arthur across the middle. It's complete, but it will be short of the first down. Nick Goodson with the catch, but he was well covered. A gain of 1. And once again, Graham will have to punt. And into the ball game will be John Grubb.
Todd Benners laid a nice stick on him as soon as he caught the ball, ensuring that there would not be a first down for the G-men.
Fourth down, Grubb into punt. Takes a 12-yard drop, fumbles the ball, and he's going to be tackled back at the 14-yard line. Grubb couldn't get a handle on the low snap, and by the time he did, the Beaver defenders had come through and tackled him, and that's another big break for Bluefield.
Definite advantage for Bluefield. Something that Coach Colabro pointed out on the show, Graham teams or Coach Carlock teams usually don't make many mistakes. You have to beat them.
So Bluefield takes over on the 14, first and 10. They're trying to put this one away early, Matt.
I'm shocked, Ralph. I really am. This is a total surprise.
Stacy Carter, quarterback. Coach Fred Simon certainly got to be pleased with his team's performance so far. Up. Here's a pitch. Left side. It's Scott. Gets to the outside.
Hey, what a move.
Shake and bake, stopped both guys in their tracks, and he went in untouched. Beautiful run.
So in some cases where you wouldn't really call the punt a turnover, that mistake immediately cost Graham with now 20-0, a 14-yard run by Scott with 4:06 to go in the second quarter. And now Arnold on once again to try to make it 3-for-3 on the extra point. Arnold in position. Snap a little high, it gets down, the kick is up, nice. And the kick is good. Arnold with three solid kicks. So with 4:06 to go in the second quarter, that's for Bluefield 21 and Graham 0. Bluefield showing a potent offense and a very stiff defense.
Yeah, the size is definitely an advantage for Bluefield, and the people on Bluefield's side have got to be ecstatic the way the offense has just come out storming in the first half.
No one really knew what to expect, as we've talked about all night. A lot of question marks on both sides. And a kick, Paul Willis, the deep man, for Graham. There's number 22, Rick Ferris. There's the kick rolling on the ground first. We'll take it to the 15 across the 20. The 25. Looking left. Outside. Has the room if he can get around Stecklein. But Stecklein with a nice tackle at the 25. He had the right idea, but Stecklein didn't let him outside.
He had the angle on him and closed it down quickly.
That's the key thing that always hear coaches talk about on kickoff. There's a man responsible to keep the outside closed. And I'll tell you what, if you're the outside man and you let the runner get, you might as well just keep running because you don't want to see your coach after
that. That's right, outside contain. I know, I lived that once. Believe me, I know.
The key is never to have to be that outside man. All you can do is mess up.
That's right.
So Graham now will try to get something going. 3:45 to go here in the second quarter. They've got a first and 10 at the 20, at their own 25. How wide to the left is Johnson? They're looking to him. It's passed over his way in his hands, and he took his eyes off it. It's incomplete. I think he was thinking about running. He just got moving too quickly.
How many times have you seen it in any sport? Trying to take off before the ball gets there. And I'm looking, Ralph, for Graham has to open up their offense. They've got to mix it up and get it more passing in their offense.
Second down and 10 from the 25. They'll look left side again. This time it is complete. The Bluefield there to stop Johnson very quickly, a gain of about 2.
Benner's made that stop. They've got to start throwing it deep. They've got to.
Third down and 8 yards. Cut in. We have Grubb and Ferris, I imagine, with some instructions from the sideline. And Matt, you seem to favor the long ball here tonight.
Well, they've got to, every play has been in front of the Bluefield defense. They've got to open it up, keep them on their toes.
See what happens here, 2:55. There's still time to do something for either team
no
here.
No question.
They're going to draw. Try it up the middle, good play, and we've got a lot of room there. I believe that was John Grubb,
close to the first.
And I think he's going to get it just across the 35. Good draw play there.
Looks like Bluefield was thinking the same way I was thinking. Look for the deep pass, and they mix it up with the draw. Nice call.
Back our third quarterback. Rolls right, looking for the pass. Has a man out there, but just over the head of Bradshaw. Again, that touch pass, just trying to get it over the head of the defenders, but just a little too far for Bradshaw. Stops the clock with 2:28 to go in the second quarter.
Once again, the defensive pressure forced a hurried offensive play.
Of course, as always, this is the first game of the season for both these clubs. Great crowd on hand. Whole crowd, or full capacity at Mitchell. Here's the pass. Left side is intercepted. In on the interception. Let's check that.
Benners picked it up.
Gets the interception. The pass was intended for, I believe, Goodson. But Benners on the interception, and Bluefield will take over at the 45 with 2:22 to go. Good defense there, Matt.
Beautiful play. You know, Arthur, he's young. He's going to get better as the season goes along. It's just his first game. And I think both teams will definitely improve as we go along.
Now we'll see if Bluefield tries to get some more points on the board here. They've run the ball magnificently tonight. It's Carter, he's going to fake it. He's going to look over the middle. And he's going to be knocked down. Good defense by Lance Barber. Barber came in from the left side. It looked like Carter was going to have time, but that would be a loss of about 8 yards.
Stecklein was just breaking open, too, down the sideline, left sideline.
Clock running with 1:45 now remaining. We've got the Bluefield band getting ready to go on the field, along with the... A lot of people here tonight.
Floyd Race checked in.
Stephon comes out of the ball game. Second down, we'll call it about 17. See if they try to put it up in the air again.
That's what
they're going to do.
Good pressure. Carter
screen.
Left.
Screen
pass
complete. All in all, Arnold dropped it in the backfield. Probably all for the better because I think it would have been for a loss. He rolled right and set up the screen left, but Graham saw it, and it's incomplete. It'll be third down, 17, clock stop, 1:17 to go. Third down and 18. Tight to the left. Let's watch him.
Here's good pressure.
A heavy
good
rush
pressure.
Again. Carter gets rid of it, but it's incomplete. Carter just dumped that ball. Good presence of mind by the quarterback.
Pat
they
hit
him nail. And a kick, Todd Benners. Benners, good snap. It's a hard end-over-end kick. Fair catch is called for. Fumble, but they'll control it. That was number 23, Palmer. Falls down on it at the 18-yard line.
Coach Carlock's got to be pleased with the last two defensive series.
Last touchdown, Ronnie Scott, a beautiful move, a 14-yard run around the left side. And now it's Graham's turn. They try the handoff on the draw play. Bradshaw with some room, but only up to the 25. And the clock now down to 30 seconds and carry.
Hurry up offense, no huddle. And they better hurry up.
Clock now down to 19 seconds. Let's see if Arthur puts it up in the air. And off second man through Bradshaw again. He's got some room up across the 30. Up to the 35, and he'll be tackled there. And I'll stop the clock when they move the chains with 7 seconds to go. Graham might have a chance to get one more playoff. He might need some trickery here.
Halfback option, maybe shotgun offense. A surprise, a shotgun offense for Graham.
They've got everybody spread out.
Hail Mary.
Right, they throw the Hail Mary up in the air. Down the middle, it's going to be intercepted by Bluefield. And then
he's got some blockers.
To run this back.
He's got some blockers.
Carter.
He could go. He's gone. He's gone.
He's
going
to go across the 20 to the 10. And we have a touchdown, but we have a flag down on the field. Carter went left, came right, but we have a flag down. And we'll have to take a look.
Clip. Had to be a clip. Had to be a clip.
Graham playing deep on defense. G-men have done a good job rushing Carter so far tonight. Let's see what they do here. It's going to be a pitch. Right side, not much room there.
Hairston, beautiful tackle.
On Wallace, and that's going to end our half. So, both teams are going to the locker. Bluefield obviously very happy as they lead Graham 21-0. We'll be back to talk about the first half, and then we'll have a second half in just a moment on the WDBA High School Football Game of the Week. Welcome back to Mitchell Stadium. I'm Ralph Oakley along with Matt Fumu at halftime. And somewhat of a surprise, I would say, for everyone here. Bluefield leading 21-0 over Graham.
It's been an interesting first half, Matt.
Very interesting, very surprising, as you said. Bluefield offense ran the ball great all first half. Beautiful offensive run. They scored first off, 9:48. Benners 25 yards out, gave them the early lead. And that sort of put a shock into the Graham defense.
We'll be back with the start of the third quarter in a moment. Bluefield leads 21-0. This is the WBBA High School Game of the Week. I'm Ralph Hope along with Ben Puno, just getting ready for the start of the second half. Bluefield on top, 21-0, three running touchdowns. Graham's got their hands full, and now to call the second half, here's Matt Fumo.
Thank you, Ralph. I tell you what, it's very surprising the way Bluefield has come out smoking in the first half. As we've been hitting on all night, Bluefield's offense had a lot of question marks, and nobody expected them to be this good, and they've come out and really done a great job offensively. Now it's Graham's turn to turn around and get some offense going, because one more score and this thing's history.
Well, the speed of Bluefield was probably the story of the first half. A couple of costly mistakes and turnovers for Graham. We'll have to see. They might have to open up the offense because they've got a lot of ground to pick up. Graham will be kicking off to Bluefield, and we're just about ready to get started with the second half.
Here goes the kick, and it's a bad kick off the side, out of bounds. It'll go, and we'll have a penalty, and we'll redo it again. Back deep for Bluefield will be Todd Benners, Paul Wallace, and Floyd Ray. Beautiful night for football, as we've talked about. And here's the kick. Nice kick this time. Benner's at about the 12.
breaks it outside, upended at about the 22-yard line, and that's where the Beavers will take over on offense.
John Grubb on the tackle. This could be a really important series for Graham. As we mentioned, they had one nice sustained drive in the first half, weren't able to score. Their defense stiffened then for Coach Carlock a little bit in the second half. If they can hold them here and not give up much yardage, Bluefield would have to punt. Graham would probably get the ball in pretty good field position, something they haven't had tonight.
That's right. It seemed that when Bluefield went to their passing offense, that's when the Graham defense rose to the occasion. We'll see what happens now. Carter over center. The pitch to Wallace. Nice move inside. He could be gone. He's to the 40, down to the 35, down to 30. He gets the block and he's gone. 10-5, touchdown Wallace for Bluefield. Heck of a run.
Beautiful run down the left side. Just made an outstanding cut. Again, the blocking was good.
Ronnie Scott, beautiful run. Cut it inside, hit the outside, and he was gone. He got the block at about the 15, ran it into the end zone. And as we said, one more score could have iced it, and this could have done it.
So a 72-yard run there, and that's going to really make it difficult for Graham to come back.
You know, it's hard not to keep harping on the same thing, but Bluefield's speed is just incredible. Scott made a beautiful run there. Red is blocking well, got a key block down at about the 20, brought it into the end zone. Steve Arnold now will come on to kick the extra point. And this is quickly turning into a rout.
Arnold's been perfect so far tonight.
The snap. Dead center kick. 11:26 left in the third quarter. Bluefield surprisingly up over Graham, 28-0. And Ralph, that was one whale of a run.
But you just continue to see the speed, the good blocking. Again, we've talked about the question marks both teams face coming into the season with the preseason rankings. Certainly Princeton was mentioned. They've got a good club. Beckley was mentioned. Bluefield not given a mention primarily on the disappointing season they had last year. Fred Simon has said this is a rebuilding year. But if this is any indication, Coach Joe Tribuco has been scouting this game. I imagine he'll go back to this club and say, look, we're going to have our hands full come mid-October when we play this club.
I'll tell you what, this has got to be a heartbreaker for Graham. You get fired up, you get your adrenaline going again in the second half, then the first play from scrimmage, they break a 72-yard run, and Bluefield has now got a 28-zip lead early in the third quarter. Back deep for the Graham G-men will be Rick Ferris, Tony Palmer, and John Grubb. And here's the kick. It'll be short, taken by Hairston at the 25 to the 30, and he'll be drilled out of bounds at about the 32-yard line. That's where Graham will start on offense.
Short kick, but outstanding coverage by Bluefield, leading the way there, number 70, John Lambert. But a little better field position for Graham at the 32.
It'll definitely help him starting this with the end zone not right in their heels. Arthur will be at quarterback again for the G-men, and I look for them to open it up a little bit, Ralph. They're down by four touchdowns. They've got to open it up. All right, here we go. Graham, Arthur over center, the stacked eye. Palmer now splits out wide to the right at the flank position. And we're going to have a motion, Paul.
Rusty Bradshaw. Before the snap there, that'll be 5 yards.
So things aren't going exactly the way Graham coach Glenn Carlock would want at the start of the second half.
As we mentioned earlier, man, we've got a lot of great ball games coming up. We'll be back in a couple of weeks on Saturday, the 12th of September, 12:30 p.m. We'll have the coverage of the Greenbrier East at Bluefield game. Then on the 19th of September, Richlands at Tazewell. Saturday, October 3rd, Mount View at Princeton. Then on the 17th of October, Princeton-Bluefield. That's always a big
battle.
That
will be a good one.
And then the 24th of October, Parkersburg at Woodrow Wilson-Beckley. And then rounding out the season on November the 1st, we'll have George with at Graham. And that's a game that could have some bearing on Virginia playoffs.
It sure could. Here we go. First and 15 for the Graham G-men. Arthur at the quarterback. Inside handoff it goes, and Bluefield stacks it up for after gain about 2 or 3 yards.
I think we might have had a fumble, but it was after the whistle.
Second and 12 now for the G-men from the 30-yard line. Luther Johnson wide out left. Arthur barks the signals. Inside handoff to Hairston, and he's not going to get much, Ralph. Johnson out wide to the left. Parker split. Arthur on the drop. He looks, he throws, and it's incomplete right off the hands of Tony Palmer. And they're going to be in punt formation, and Bluefield will get the ball in pretty good field position again.
Palmer was there, Matt, just a little bit off, just a little ahead of him. He made a dive for it just off the fingertips. Right idea.
The right idea, and he had some room, too, if it was on the money. So it's punt time for the Graham G-men, and things aren't going well as we start the third quarter for the G-men. Back deep for Bluefield is Todd Benners and Paul Wallace. Here's the snap, good snap. Not the greatest of kicks. It'll be downed at midfield by the G-men, and there's a flag on the play. After the 15-yard penalty on Graham for interference, Bluefield with great field position. They're at the 35 of Graham. Handoff up the middle. It's Miller. He made a nice move. He got about 8 on that play, Ralph. Right up the middle. Broke a couple of tackles. Quick hitting fullback dive. Charlie Thompson out wide for Bluefield. In motion. And it's a counter play. Wallace, we got a flag. A referee stopping.
I think
the knee went down. That's right. The knee went down.
Carter was tripped as he pitched the ball off to Wallace, but his knee had hit the ground, so he was down.
8:48 to go in the third quarter. 28-0. Bluefield on top and looking for more. They keep it inside. And it looks like they're going to be close to it. Looks like they're going to be just an inch or so short.
I don't think there's much question. I wouldn't think there's much question.
Oh, no, I would. Not with a 4-touchdown lead. So we got fourth and about an inch for Bluefield at the 24-yard line of Graham. They lead at 28-0, 8:28 to go in the third quarter. Beaver stacking in. It's just a keeper. Carter will get the first down. And things are definitely rolling the Bluefield Beavers' way. It's definitely time for Graham's defense to hunker down. They've definitely got to put a stop to the offensive splurging by the Bluefield Beavers. I formation for Bluefield. Carter on the drop. And he is downed at about the 35 or so.
He slipped down there as he was trying to set the pass. He slipped down, maybe an indication of still some damage on the field, but that's really the first time we've seen that happen tonight.
It seems that when the Bluefield Beavers go to their passing offense, their offense sort of sputters a little bit, Ralph. They've been very successful running the ball. Passing, they've had a little trouble, and Graham's defensed them well when they have gone to the pass.
I was going to say, and to Graham's credit, they have put a heavy pressure on Carter every time he's gone back to pass.
I formation for the Beavers. Carter on the drop. Inside handoff. That's Scott. He breaks a couple of tackles. And he's got about 12 yards on that run, Ralph. That was a heck of a run inside.
He's got to be over 100 yards for the night. He's starting the season the way you want to. No question about it. Scott, a 161-pound junior. A lot of young kids starting on both sides.
That's right. Benners will check into the game. Scott comes out. Fred Simon has got to be pleased with the offense of Bluefield. Steckline checks in as well. And out comes Wallace. Thompson and Steckline out wide right. Carter on the option. It's a keeper. He finally pitches it back. And not the smartest of plays there, as they lost a couple on that play. That was Todd Benners. And he made a heck of a play just to grab the ball because the pitch wasn't where he wanted it.
I think Carter said his good friend Benners up there for a human sacrifice. But that was a dangerous play. He hung in there and made a good pitch to Benners. And Benners held on to it, but there was not much chance. And now it looks like we're going to have a field goal try. Conceivably, or let's see, that's what it
that's
is going to be. It looks like they'll place it at the 30, so that'll be a 40-yard
field goal.
He certainly got the leg for it.
Yes, he does. The snap, the hold, the kick, it's up. And it is no good. Wide left a little bit. So with 6:02 to go in the third quarter, Bluefield Beavers still lead it by Graham, 28-0. Go. Back here, 6:02 to go in the third quarter. Graham ball from their own 20. Rusty Bradshaw split out wide right for the G-men. The pitch goes back, and great defensive play by Bluefield again. Their defensive line has just been all over the field. Grubb had no room to go anywhere on that play.
Quinn just has not been able to get to the outside at all. On a couple of runs early in the first half, but that hadn't been the case. We now have 5:40 to go in the third quarter.
They've got a long way to go. Second and 15 now. They've got to start opening up the offense. Johnson goes wide left. The pitch goes nowhere to run again. Bradshaw drilled behind the line of scrimmage, and Graham's offensive line is not having the best of nights. Third and about 3 miles now for Graham. Deep in their own end. They need some kind of offense to get this thing in gear. 5:02 left in the third quarter.
Graham's kind of the bookends for the season for us. The first game and then the last game of the year. They'll be playing George Whip.
I'm sure we'll see a lot of improvement throughout the season for Graham.
I know one thing, it'll be colder 2 months from now.
On the drop, incomplete that was. Arthur threw a nice ball in there, but Bluefield was all over.
Outstanding coverage here by Bell.
Chris Ware had two guys around him, and it was really a tough pass to try to complete, especially deep in your own territory. So it'll be punt time once again for the G-men. Grubb on the punt. He just gets it off.
Good kick.
Benner's from the 46. And he's got some room on the outside if he can get there. And they'll just take it out at about the 42-yard line. Once again, Bluefield will start in great field position from the Graham 42-yard line. I look for Bluefield to keep the ball on the ground. Ralph, they had some great momentum. And it looks like they will have this game well intact if they don't make any mistakes.
I want to credit Chris Ray there. He was kind of the second line of defense. I think Benner's with his speed could have gotten around the corner. Ray, rather than rush up and try to get him, hung back and just kind of forced him to the sideline.
Closed down
good
the
job
angle.
Of defense. We talk about that outside man all the time.
That's right. That's right. 4:32 to go, third quarter. 28-0 Bluefield up. Excellent field position first from the 42nd yard line. Handoff goes to Wallace. He's trying to get outside. He'll get there. Knocked out of bounds at about the 32-yard line. And a little extracurricular activity on Graham's part. That was number 22, Rick Ferris, with a hit after he was out of bounds, but no flags thrown on the play. On the roll is Carter. He looks. He's got Stecklin. He's got the first down, and he could go. Heck of a run. He's knocked out of bounds about the 8-yard line there, and once again, the Beavers are knocking on the door.
I'll tell you what, he was able to break two tackles. The first one just on the old classic straight arm. Use the straight arm stick line. Gets down, they'll mark it at the 12. It's apparently stepped on the sideline there. And Bluefield just continues to really move that football.
They are showing they do have quite an offense. Charlie Thompson limped off there for Bluefield. We hope he's all right. It doesn't look like it's anything too serious. So we got it first from about the 12-yard line for Bluefield. And Graham is in trouble. Carter on the roll left. He's being pressured. He fires. Overthrowing Stecklin, it'll be second down. And it looks like Carter is shaken up here, Ralph. Cramp.
Temperature not very high tonight, but there's a humidity, a stickiness in the air. And the excitement of the first game, although these kids are in great shape, playing your first game is different regardless of how hard you practice. All these kids are in good shape. It's just a little different than playing the third game.
That's right, that's right. It'll take a while. Second and 10 now from the 12-yard line for Bluefield. 4:11 to go, third quarter. 28-0, the Beavers lead it. And they're knocking on the doors for some more.
And Carter's out of the ballgame, so let's see who's going to be a quarterback.
Looks like Benner's will be taking the snap. Todd Benner's will take the snap while Carter sits out and gets that cramp.
I didn't know. He's done so many good things, and I didn't know he could do this.
Well, we'll find out what happens. Benner's just takes it up the middle. On the old quarterback keeper, he got about three or four.
I think we're going to see Carter right back here in a minute.
Oh, yeah.
Look, here he comes. Probably a wise play call by Coach Simon. Benner's hadn't really taken a snap so far this year, and they knew Carter was going back. Just play it safe. No point in trying something fancy, losing the football down in this territory.
Along with Carter Ray, or Paul Wallace has checked in the game for Bluefield. Third down and about six to go. Carter turns, pitches out. That's Wallace. He doesn't have any room. Beautiful tackle there. That was number 23 for Graham, Tony Palmer. He made the nice stick.
Outstanding defensive play by Palmer out of the defensive secondary. And now we've got fourth down. Let's see what's going to happen.
Field goal time for the Beavs.
On that last 40-yard attempt by Arnold, he had plenty of leg, just a little
just wide. Just a little left. May got under the ball a little bit, but hey, he's got a heck of a leg for a high school kicker.
He very quickly, of course, has a kicking shoe. He's a straight-on kicker. And he's got it changed into that kicking shoe very quickly. As he plays, of course, both ways, and then has to put on the kicking shoe. It'll be marked at the 17, a 27-yard attempt.
Here's a snap, the hold, the kick. No good again.
Wide to the left. That's a real tough angle on the far hash mark. Again, plenty of distance, just wide to the left. That stays 28-0.
All right, 2:46 left in the third quarter. Graham ball from the 20. They're down by 28. They need to get some offense going. Arthur on the drop, and he's going to get drilled. He had no time. He just sat back and just got popped. But that guy was
Joe Street, I believe.
Number 50, Joe Street.
I think what was happening, they were looking for a quick slant in, so he didn't take much of a drop back. His man was covered, and then there was nowhere to go.
That puts the quarterback in a tough position. When you drop back, expect to see your wide receiver, and you've got a 250-pound linebacker in your face.
He's probably not smiling.
No, I'm sure he wasn't too happy to see that. Second and about 13 now for Graham.
Or maybe if he was that close, he was smiling.
Wide out right goes Chris Ray. The delayed draw, nowhere. Nowhere. Joe Street once again with the big hit for Bluefield. He's back there about as much as the Graham running backs are.
Counting down now, 1:45 to go in the third quarter.
You got to wonder what is going through Coach Carlock's mind to call offensively. Nothing seems to be working for the Graham G-men.
It's going to be awfully difficult to rack up 28 points in one quarter. Do you want to concentrate on the fundamentals here? It's a long season.
That's right. That's right. Quick handoff inside. That's
Grubb.
John Grubb. And he's going to be way short of the first down. And once again, Graham will be forced to punt. And Bluefield should get pretty good field position.
Recapping the scoring early on in the ball game, Benner's with the 25-yard touchdown. That got it started. Then Bluefield scored twice in the second quarter, and then the run by Scott, the 72-yarder, in the start of the third quarter. That was the first play of the third quarter.
That's right.
That makes it 28-0.
Benner's and Wallace back deep for Bluefield. Nice snap. Kick is off. Beautiful spiral kick. That's going to be Benner from the 36-yard line. Nice block he gets up to the 50, and he's still on his feet. The 45 and knocked out of bounds at about the 46-yard line. A heck of a run back for Todd Benner. And Bluefield once again will start in good field position.
Outstanding block by Gravely, who first got Benner loose to pick up that yardage.
So it'll be Bluefield first and 10 from the 43-yard line of Graham, and so far, except for the very first offensive possession of the third quarter where they ran for 73 yards, Bluefield's had the ball in Graham territory. 36 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Beavers up by four touchdowns. Carter on the roll right. He's getting some pressure. Beautiful tackle there. That's number 43, Rodney Hairston. He chased him down and made the play. Big loss for the Beavers. Nice defensive play by Graham.
That's going to be about a 12-yard loss. Hairston shows some of his quickness there by running down Carter. He's not exactly slow.
No, he's not. Heck of a defensive play, and that'll be it for the third quarter, it looks like. 5 seconds to go. And that's it. That's the end of the third quarter. Graham and Bluefield Beavers lead at 28-0.
at the end of the third quarter. This is the WBBA High School Football Game of the Week. Start of the fourth quarter, Bluefield up 28-0. Carter, the pitch to Wallace, he's got some room. Nice run, and he gained about 8 yards on that play. It'll be third and about 12 now for Bluefield.
Up across midfield to the 47 there. It seems like we're a broken record, but that speed and the good blocking has done the job for Coach Fred Simon tonight.
Third and 13, Carter on the drop. He's getting pressure. Hairston once again from the left side, and he drilled him for the big loss. And it's punt time for Bluefield, something they haven't done often tonight.
It'll be the third punt for Bluefield. From Coach Glenn Carlock's perspective, certainly there have been some positive things. I think the defensive pass rush has been one of the real outstanding points for the G-men tonight, and there has been some sustained offense. Graham has some things that they're doing well and some things certainly they want to improve upon.
No question about it. They have a lot of positives to build on. And here we pick up the punt. There will not be a run back on this one. Graham will down it at about the 26-yard line, or Bluefield, I should say, will down it on the 26-yard line. That's where Graham will take over. 10:35 to go in the fourth quarter. Graham down by four touchdowns. And they're going to start at about the 28-yard line.
Don't forget, Matt will be back with Tony Calabro in 2 weeks, Saturday, September the 12th from 12:30 to 2 p.m. Greenbrier East at Bluefield here at Mitchell Stadium. That should be a good ball game. 7 games in total this year. Hope you can join us for every one of them.
Graham breaks the huddle, comes up the center is Arthur once again, and they keep it on the ground. Looks like that was number 25, John Grubb, and he didn't get a whole heck of a lot on that one. Once again, the size of Bluefield is showing in this game.
We'll probably start seeing some substitution in the ballgame now, give everybody an opportunity to play. Of course, that's important because that game experience, just getting a chance to play in the game, get that initial nervousness out of the way, can be very important to both clubs.
Second, and it looks like 10 as well, 9:57 to go in the fourth quarter. Graham down by four, and they've been keeping the ball on the ground. Arthur at the quarterback, 5'10", sophomore for Graham. Grubb again on the counter, and he got about maybe two yards on that play. .9:30 left now in the fourth quarter, 28-0, Bluefield over Graham. Graham's got a long way to go to get back into this ball game. But you know, Ralph, like you said, there is a lot to build on for Graham. Their defensive pass coverage and pass rush has been really good, and that is something to look that Coach Carler can look back on and say, hey, we did good job at this. The pitch is back. That's number 22, Rick Ferris, and he's going to get eaten up for no gain, and it'll be punt time once again for the Graham G-men, and Bluefield's defense has played one whale of a ball game.
Starting to see some of those new players in the ball game. Brian Hoops just in the ball game for the first time for Graham on that play. Now they'll have to give it up with the punt.
Benners and Wallace once again back deep for Bluefield. And as we've said many times, they should get pretty good field position out of this punt as well. 8:34 and running in the fourth quarter. Grub the kick for Graham. No rush at all. Sort of a shank for... And it'll be down at about the 49-yard line where Bluefield will take over with 8:10 left to go in the ballgame. They lead it 28-0 and have been very impressive both offensively and defensively.
Amazingly, we've had a lot of people sticking around here. I thought as we get started the fourth quarter, more would be leaving, but with 8:10 to go, so most of the people are here tonight. It's been a great night to be out in football. It's kind of always the signal of fall here, I think.
Well, everybody is up for the first game. It's a good time of year. Everybody enjoys football in the area, and it's something that everyone looks forward to. So even though I'm sure the Graham people aren't really ecstatic about the way things have gone, hey, it's football, and they're just glad to see everybody out there busting their tails to play. Carter, hands fall off. That is Scott. Plenty of running room. Fumbled it, though.
We're going to have to try to dig it out for you as the referees try to see who's got the ball. And it is Bluefield's ball. Lucky break. When things are going your way, they're going your way.
And they really seem to try to check and see who made that recovery. It was one lineman I could not quite see. I'll have to check it in a minute. But it looked for him all like Bradshaw had his hands on it for Graham, but he was falling away from the ball and wasn't able to hold on.
It'd have been a tough play. First and 10 now from the 30 for Bluefield.
I think it was maybe Muncy with the recovery.
Inside handoff stacked up, and we got a flag on the play. Face masking, it will be against Graham. That's the third face mask tonight we've had in this ball game.
That'll be a 15-yard penalty. That'll take the ball down in the vicinity of the 16-yard line. So Bluefield once again knocking on the door. You know, you can tell football was here. You came to the game. We came, of course, or I came at least before the crowds, the traffic jams. But depending upon which street you came in on, you saw either Bluefield streamers everywhere. If you came from the Virginia side, you saw the Graham streamers. There was not much question that there was a football game tonight and who was involved.
Wall-to-wall cars. It took about 25 minutes to get down to just from the TV station. So
that
you
was
can
an
tell
hour and a half prior to the ball game.
That's right. We pick it up now, first and 10. Carter hands it off to Wallace. He trips. It'll be down at about the 15-yard line. 7 minutes to go in the ball game.
Few of the people now starting to file out. Well, we were able to get this ball game in without a lot of nasty weather. Everybody had their umbrellas and only had to use them for about 5 minutes before the game.
And as we said, the rain probably didn't have too much of an effect on the ball game. Only a couple plays that seemed like there was a slip here and there, but pretty much it's been a beautiful night for football. Carter hands it to Scott. He breaks it. He's in there. Touchdown, Bluefield.
Looking at that play on the replay, Scott with his third touchdown tonight. It was wide open, and he just scooted through for a 15-yard touchdown, making it 34-0.
I'll tell you what's impressive. Not only the team speed of Bluefield, but their backs read their blocks very, very well. He cut it back inside, made another nice move, touchdown, and that is one thing that the Bluefield Beavers' backs do real well. They read their blocks well. That's good coaching. That's a sign of good coaching and intelligent ball players.
I have a feeling the next time that there's a vote around the state for the best teams in the state, Bluefield may get a little notice.
I think they're definitely going to, people are going to open their eyes here. The extra point we blocked by Graham. That was number 51, Tim Hall, on the block. So with 6:34 to go in the ball game, Bluefield Beavers on a roll, 34-0. Back here at Mitchell Stadium, 6:34 to go in a ball game. And what can you say about the Bluefield Beavers? Nobody expected this, and they're blowing out the Graham G-men.
I'll tell you what, they have really impressed everybody with their speed, good blocking, good solid defense as well. So I imagine Fred Simon is just real pleased with tonight's result.
I'm sure he is. Ferris, Palmer, and Grubb back deep for the G-men as they try to get something going here late in the ball game. It's a good kick. It'll be Ferris from about the 12. He's up to the 20. He runs into a pile, spins away, heads out to the right sideline, up to the 30, to the 35, into the 40, and knocked out of bounds at about the 44-yard line. Heck of a run there.
Floyd Ray saved the day. I'll tell you what, a great run by Ferris. Found the opening. Floyd Ray got over there just at the last minute. If he got by him, he was gone because he had blockers. But good job by Ray and a good run by Ferris.
Excellent run. Excellent run. He got stacked up in the middle, made the spin move to the right, and hit to the sidelines.
We haven't calculated Ronnie Scott's rushing average tonight, but it's double digits.
Definitely. 72-yard run. That other one was about a 20-yard run. Offensive flash and firepower by the Bluefield Beavers, and we got a timeout by Bluefield. All right, Graham G-Man set to go from their 44-yard line, first and 10. 6:24 left in the ballgame. Arthur on the drop. Intended for number 86, Chris Ray. A little high there. Nice effort, though, by Ray.
Again, good coverage by Bluefield. They're hanging back. They're willing to give up the short pass.
And that's about the only tight pass Graham has attempted the whole evening, is the short, safe pass.
We had the scouts, as we mentioned tonight, from Princeton here, Coach Joe Carrico and his staff. I'm sure they were very impressed with what they saw.
Well, Coach Trebucca knew that Bluefield had the speed. I don't know if he knew they had this much speed and they'd be this impressive, but he definitely got something to go back and tell his players that. Arthur on the drop. It's a screen. That's number 23, Tony Palmer, with the ball, and he's made a nice run all the way down to the 40-yard line of Bluefield.
Good play by Palmer. It's a nicely set up screen pass. Palmer got out a little bit ahead of the blockers and was able to get the first down. It was 6:07. Looks like Graham may move the ball here. I'm sure they'd like to get on the board.
Yeah, score a touchdown, I think, would be a good emotional lift for the offense, especially for the young quarterback, Arthur, who's just a sophomore in his first game.
Made a nice pass there.
Definitely, he sure did, and he handled the pressure well. He had three or four chunks of beef in his face. Arthur to Palmer on the delay. Palmer makes a nice move, and he's got about 9 yards on that run.
As we mentioned, we're seeing some new people in the football game. We're trying to mention those people to you. Ron Morris in on the front line for Bluefield. Also, Tyrone Murray, 5'6", sophomore, number 45 is in the football game.
It'll be second and two from Graham. From the 32-yard line of Bluefield, 5:20 to go in the ball game. Ferris splits out wide right for the G-men. Arthur, the quick handoff to Harrison. He breaks out of the line, and he's got the first down for the G-men at about the 24-yard line of Bluefield.
Certainly one of the concerns for Coach Glenn Carlock, he's had a couple people knocked out of this football game. We'll have to see about their status. Jeff Browning early in the ball game was knocked out, and Jay Johnson was knocked out. And how serious those injuries are, we're not sure. Of course, he lost a couple of people earlier this week in a car accident to injuries, a broken leg. So a couple of problems that the G-men are going to have to deal with.
And you don't really know how much of an effect that had on the game and on the team itself. Arthur, the quick pass again, off the hand, and it's intercepted by Scott, and here he goes. You better look out. Cuts it back to the inside. He's still on his feet. Down at the 40-yard line.
Good interception. That's the tip. That's the example of the tip drill they do in practice. It was off the hands of Ray. He kept his eyes on it, made the interception, and gets it back to the 41-yard line. Now 4:32 to go in the ballgame.
And things are going your way. They're going your way as they are for Bluefield. Everything seems to be going their way. They're catching all the breaks. And for Graham, you got to feel a little bit sorry for them. They're having a tough night.
I think we got some new players coming in the football game now for Bluefield.
All right, we pick it up, 4:32 to go in the ball game. Bluefield ball from the 40-yard line. And there's not much happening there. Nice play by Tim Hall of Graham as he got into the backfield about the time the center snapped the ball to Floyd Ray, who is now quarterbacking for Bluefield.
Ray, a sophomore, only 5'5". Well, it was a great opportunity, young sophomore, to get some game experience. 4:10 to go.
Bench clearing time, and you need that. You never know if Carter went down, this guy'd have to play. Ray over center, 2nd and 12 for Bluefield. Hand off up the middle, that's number 11, Paul Wallace, and he got about 4 on the way.
Whitzer Gilbert in the game now. Also coming in is Gravely. Also in the backfield, going both ways, is Tyrone Murray.
They're down in about 9 now for Bluefield, 3:35 to go in the ball game. Things have definitely gone the Beaver way tonight. Eye formation. Floyd on the pitch. That's Wallace. Penalty flag, 2 penalty flags. Now that was number 23, Tony Palmer, who pulled the face mask of Wallace, and there was a flag thrown before that, probably a clipping or a hold.
I think we had a push from the back was the first penalty. We'll have to wait and see.
That was a vicious face mask right there. I had to sting a little bit, I'm sure.
Those penalties negate one another.
Maybe a little frustration on Graham's part. Nobody wants to come out in their first ball game and get blown out.
Don't forget to join us in 2 weeks, Saturday, September the 12th, 12:30 to 2 p.m., Greenbrier East of Bluefield.
I got a word of warning for the Spartans. They better be coming down here ready to play some football.
they'll have an eye. They're watching this ball game and taking a few notes. Easy way for the coaches to scout. Sit their easy chair.
Eye formation. Wallace once again up the middle. He'll be short of the first down. And with 2:57 and counting in the game, it'll be punt formation for Bluefield. They lead it 34-0. And quite an awesome display both offensively and defensively for the Beavers. Bradshaw back deep along with Palmer for Graham to receive the punt.
Only the fourth punt tonight for Bluefield.
And there's a flag. Nice kick. Fair catch call for Palmer at the 26-yard line. Flag on the play.
Bluefield band right below us. Really banging out the tunes. They're pretty happy with good reason.
We heard you were going to do your Harry Carey impression of singing here at the ballpark. Are we going to get it or not, Rob? What do you think?
I think it's in everyone's best interest, probably particularly my own, that you don't.
Well, maybe we'll give you a guest appearance next week. All right, we pick it up. First and 10 for the G-men. Mike Patton is now taking the snap from center for the G-men. Luther Johnson split out wide left, and they keep it on the ground. Up the middle it'll go. And not much room, and that's pretty much been the story all night for the Graham offense.
Bradshaw trying to take that one up the middle. Patton, the quarterback, 5'6", a sophomore.
This one's winding down, 1:49 to go in the ballgame. Bluefield Beavers very impressive tonight, both offensively and defensively. They got a lot of size and a lot of speed, and the way things are going now, looks like they may have a very successful season.
Looks like Tony Yoon is maybe coming as center for the G-men.
Chris Way Ray, a wide out. In motion goes number 32, Marcus Latimer. Handoff up the middle once again, and once again, not much room. Palmer didn't have a whole lot of daylight there.
Well, certainly, it's an important football game. The rivalry between Graham and Bluefield, and of course, Bluefield getting the better of it tonight. But it's a long season, and of course, I'm sure Glenn Carlock is most interested in trying to get to the playoffs, and this does not necessarily materially diminish those chances. So that's the important thing. They've just got to put this one behind them and learn what they can learn and go forward, and I'm sure they will.
That's right, and if anybody's got the experience, it's Coach Carlock. He's been around, and he's been a winner. Quick counter play once again. That was Palmer on the left side of the line. Not going to be enough for the first down, though. And, Graham has got a long way to go. They're a young team. They had to replace their whole backfield from last year. So, there's some positive things that I'm sure they'll be able to build on, and I'm sure that there's some things that he's going to want to tell them, and, hey, you did this a little bit wrong. We got to do this a little bit different. But it's a learning experience, a long way to go, and I'm sure Graham will be able to have a few W's in the column this year.
And Fred Simon, of course, got to be pleased with Bluefield's effort. 10 seconds now to go. Looks like we're going to have one last
play. Last play of the ball game right here, if they beat the snap. Last play in the game, up the middle. There's big number 71, Seth Peters, to make the final tackle. And what can you say, Ralph, but the Bluefield Beavers were just awesome tonight.
Yes, they were. 34-0. They met quite a ball game. Bluefield was impressive.
Bluefield, as everybody knew, had a lot of speed. I don't think anybody knew they had this much speed. Their size was a key. They have a lot of depth, and they just played great on both sides of the football.
Looking at the scoring, Bluefield got on early after a Graham turnover. Benners with a 25-yard run in the first quarter. In the second quarter, Miller with a 1-yard run, and then Scott with his first of three touchdowns, a 14-yarder. And then at halftime, it was 21-0. And then Ronnie's got a 72-yard run to start the third quarter, and that kind of put the nail on the coffin.
Yeah, that broke the camel's back, as they say. 72-yard run. You know, you come out at halftime, and you're expecting to do a lot better. Then the first play, boom, they break a long run, and it's sort of demoralizing.
And then the final score, a beautiful 15-yard run by Scott. That made it 34-0. For Bluefield, impressive. For Graham, what should they look forward to, you think?
Well, Graham is going to have to open up their offense a little bit. They tried to run the ball all night. Their passing was short, safe passes. And, their size hurt them as well. So they're going to have to work on that offense a little bit. But
down there. Go on ahead. I wouldn't if I were you, Trenor. You'd get about one swing, and then I'd put a hole in you big as a saucer plate.
I told you, you got the wrong man. Now, I never killed anybody, and I've never been to Junction City.
Look, Trenor, let's understand each other. You're a nice fella. If you ever try that again, I just will kill you looking at you.
Keep your hands where I can see them. Man can get killed walking up soft like that.
You wouldn't kill an officer of the law, would you?
No, sir.
Well, water hole's all yours. Sorry.
I didn't come for the water. I came for the prisoner, Randall. I'm the one that sent you that wanted circular on him.
Oh, well, what's his name?
Daniel Trenor.
What's he wanted for?
Murder in my tower.
And you?
Howard Catlett, Sheriff, Junction City. Something bothering you, Trenor?
Where did we meet?
You'll remember.
Well, you owe me $400, Sheriff. Plus room and lodging for 3 days, $23. $423 total.
$423? Afraid I'll have to owe that to you. Get on your horse, Trenor.
I don't get this.
You will. Put your hands behind your head and turn around. You take that belt off. One hand. Something to remember me by. Let's go, Trent.
Continue.